2019 is just a few days away, but forget 2019. Let's talk about 2020. Which Democrats will be running for president? There's something about Harry. I want to bring in CNN senior politics writer and analyst Harry Enten. Look, Allison Camerota is off today.
I know.
Occasionally she does watch, though, and this is for her, because Allison always says, oh, why are we talking about 2020? You know, it's too soon, it's too soon. No, it is not too soon. It's now, Harry, and you've done some calculations about when people jump into the race.
So I've been off the last few days, and I decided to go into the spreadsheets and do some work. And so I looked all the way back since 1972 and looked at the median entry date in nomination processes in which there was no incumbent running on a particular side. And what did I find? I found that the median entry date for candidates is March 12th. It's March 12th, the year before the primary. So we're just a few months out from that. And so I expect that candidates are going to start throwing their names in the ring with even more regularity as we enter the new year.
I thought you were going to say November 7th, 2018, but that's good that we've moved it out to March of 2019.
That's soon, though. That's the median, which means that half actually will come even
before.
Sooner.
That's exactly right. Half will come before. And we've obviously already seen John Delaney and Julian Castro, who just started an exploratory committee. And that, I think, is going to be one of the more interesting things, is to see whether or not some of these candidates are going to dip their toe into the water a little bit. If I was standing up, this dipping that I'm doing right now with my foot might come across a little bit better. But I'm sitting so you can't see it. But the point is, will they start with an exploratory committee, or will they just throw their name right into the ring immediately?
We have the last five nominees, in a non-incumbent field who jumped in here. Look at this. And look at Barack Obama. 2016-2007, which is 20 days from now. That is not distant from now. And look at John McCain.
John McCain, actually, this is like one of the funniest things. You know, you work with producers and you're trying to say, when did they enter? And I threw in 2006. Like, wait a minute, do you mean 2007? No, I meant 2006 for John McCain.
Yeah.
He jumped in basically 2 years ahead of the election. And indeed, if you go through all of these different names that are on there, the latest on there was Hillary Clinton, who declared on April 12, 2015. We all forget that Donald Trump actually formed an exploratory committee in March of 2015. Mm-hmm. I think that a lot of people just didn't believe he was going to actually run, but he was signaling in March that he was. So I would not be surprised if the eventual nominee for the Democratic Party actually declared or formed an exploratory committee this upcoming month.
So what are some of these folks saying on the Democratic side? You know, we know they'll love to dance around it a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, you know, I think going, we have a list that we can throw up there. But essentially what we see here is that some of them saying, oh, I'm going to make up my mind by January. That was former President Joe Biden. If you're looking at Bernie Sanders, if I'm the best candidate, I'll probably run. Senator Warren, I will take a hard look. You can also, you know, Senator Cory Booker says, I will consider running for president. Kamala Harris says, over the holiday, I'll make that decision with my family.
That's now, by the way.
That's now. I think that's what we're seeing is they are basically look like they're adhering, and we got some more candidates up there, but they're basically adhering to what the normal schedule would basically align with. It doesn't look like this is going to be one of those later years. You know, if there's some years in which something really weird happens, you look at the 1992 Democratic field, that formed very, very late. You know, Bill Clinton didn't get in until the second half of 1991. But this year, it looks like we're adhering to the normal schedule. Looks like candidates are going to get in probably January, February, March. Maybe there'll be a late one. You know, there's sometimes, you know, Wesley Clark got in very late in 2004, or Rick Perry got in very late in 2011. But I think at this point, the eventual nominee will, in fact, get in probably January, February, or March.
We're also learning that Ohio Senator Sherrod Brown is hoping to meet with former President Barack Obama. There's a part of this, when I heard it, that I thought, I mean, what is it? I just want to come kiss the ring. If I put that out there, people will know it's, I mean, does that help you or hurt you when all of a sudden the narrative is, I'd really love to meet with you?
Yeah, I just want to have a nice meeting with former President Barack Obama. Pretty pleased. No, I mean, look, Barack Obama is still the most popular person in the Democratic Party at this particular time. He is someone, if Hillary Clinton's numbers have gone way down since she lost in 2016, Barack Obama's numbers are very, very high. Favorable ratings with the overall electorate in the 60s among Democrats. 80-90%. He's about as popular with Democrats as Donald Trump is with Republicans. And so for me, I think this is someone, you know, he wants to be able to say, hey, this guy likes me. He likes me.
We have Jonathan Martin with the New York Times on later in the show, who's got a great article about Bernie Sanders and some of the troubles that Bernie Sanders is facing. And Sherrod Brown is one of the people who may be cutting into Bernie Sanders' backing, including among some staffers. People who worked in Bernie world may look at Sherrod Brown and say, hey, maybe he's the guy we want to lead us. We have you here. You look at the numbers. New Year's resolutions. Yeah. What are the statistics?
Well, I can.
What's the data?
Yeah. What does the data say? Well, I can tell you, I probably am not going to make a New Year's resolution. But you know, if you look back, there was a Maris poll at the end of 2017, a year ago, and it basically said that 44% said they were very likely or somewhat likely to make a New Year's resolution. 56% said not likely at all. I'm in that 44%. I don't know where you two generally are. I feel like if you make one, you're probably going to break one. I was listening to 1010 Wins in New York. This is one of the things I do on my day off. I listen to the news instead of appear on it.
You give them 22 minutes, they give you the world?
Exactly correct. I love their theme song. But in any event, so, you know, if you were to listen, they said that, in fact, you probably should make weekly resolutions mm-hmm. instead of making one yearly one. I don't believe in making any resolutions at all. But, you know, what's so interesting is what people are saying, what they might make their resolution. You know, if you look at the top answer over the last few years, it's, I want to be a better person, 12%. Maybe I should be a better person. Maybe I should call my mother more frequently.
It is her birthday.
It is her birthday tomorrow, so happy birthday, Mom. See, I am a good son from time to time. But you also see a lot of people who are saying, you know, I should eat healthier, lose more weight, exercise more. You know, these are types of things I think are very difficult for people to keep. Maybe they made easier ones, they might be able to keep them. So maybe they should be better people. I think we can all be a little bit better, right?
I'm going to take the under on each one of those. Now, my favorite thing, though, is there's a likely resolution maker screen, like a likely voter screen in these polls. Are you likely or somewhat likely to make a resolution?
Look, everything in politics can be applied to real life. I am not very likely at all to be able to keep a New Year's resolution, but if I were to keep one, maybe I should eat less fast food.
Show me the registered resolution makers poll next time. All right, Harry Enten, thank you very much. Appreciate it.
Thank you.